This is ridiculous. I should probably move this thing, I guess. I don't know. Oh boy. Yeah. I do kind of fit. I don't know. Good night. Right ahead on the record this morning and say that sleeping in the car was a bad idea. Badass idea. Shit. Here's the first reason it's a badass idea. Second reason it's a bad idea is the back of the car is not a flat surface, let alone a soft surface. My damn back hurts, my legs hurt, my fucking feet are frozen. I went to sleep at 2 and I woke up at 4. At 4, I was dying because it was so cold. I cranked the car, 30 minutes, let the shit get as hot as I could get inside, cocooned myself in the blanket, went to sleep. Managed to sleep until now, 7:30. There's a Starbucks not too far from here. I definitely need that shit, so let's go. First though, we gotta make a little yellow snow. I said it. Yeah, this is what we're dealing with out here in the old Colorado mountains. Holy shit. Oh yeah, the old trooper mobile just drives right off. No problem. Oh, the damn rest area is over there. What the fuck am I doing parked here? I'm just gonna drive around the corner and see what I missed last night. Holy shit, it looks like there's restrooms and everything down there. I didn't even have to make yellow snow. Damn! There's the Starbucks right there. Let's hope they're open. All right, not open. But I ran into a guy who told me that there's a drive-thru Starbucks like 5 miles down the freeway, so coffee is a must. I'm fucking frozen. All right, Frisco, Colorado. Who the hell ever heard of that? Not me, but I just spent a little over three hours here editing that freaking vlog. It took forever. Check out this fire pit. Holy shit, it feels nice. Well, that's weird. People have been throwing quarters in there. Check it out. I never heard of throwing coins in a fire pit. This was actually a lovely Starbucks to work at for the last 3 hours, and now on to Denver. I just booked my room at Ameristar. Holy shit, look at my car. Oh yeah. situation. I can check into my room. Well, I'm not supposed to be able to check in until 4, but I might be able to check in at 2. I pulled off, instead of going straight to Denver like I was going to, I pulled off here in Blackhawk to check in, but then I didn't realize I couldn't check in right away. Long story short, I've slightly altered the plans a little bit. Rather than going down to Denver and hanging out and checking out Denver for a few hours today, I'm just gonna stay here in Blackhawk for the rest of the day. I'm gonna check into my room when I can. That truck's loud as fuck and that rhymes. And then I'm going to check into the room and play poker. The rooms here are $130 a night. But if you play 4 hours of poker, you get the poker discounted room rate, which is $99. First thing I noticed inside Ameristar Casino is this. Actually, the first thing I noticed is a fireplace. How the hell do you get out of here? Thanks. From the sound of the lady on the phone, there's a reasonable chance I could check in 20 minutes. But for now, let's walk around Blackhawk a little bit and check this out. It's kind of really kind of cool looking. I'll tell you what else it is. It's freaking cold. Small, simple, basic casino. It's like a really tiny casino over here. Then there's the Lady Luck Casino over here. More than one casino has a poker room here, I know, but I think Ameristar is the best, but maybe not. There's one other one I was gonna check out. I gotta play 4 hours at Ameristar because it's worth $30 off the hotel. So essentially I'm making $750 an hour. I'm plus $750 an hour for if I play only 4 hours, obviously. The first 4 hours I'm plus $750. I didn't look at the poker room yet at Ameristar, but there's like, what they have is a $1 to $100 spread limit, and they have a $2 to $100 spread limit. The difference in the games is the blinds. Fucking hell. It's ice falling down the gutters. It's the size of the blinds and the size of the buy-in. Honestly, I'm just looking forward to being able to check into the hotel, take a shower. Soon after that, I guess I'm just gonna go play poker. See, I was gonna go down to Denver and spend a few hours just checking out Denver. But first of all, I'm super tired. Oh, I forgot, I didn't tell you the rest of the plan. The rest of the plan is that instead of going down to Denver today, I'm gonna check out Denver on my way out tomorrow. So here's the Monarch Casino, and there's the Isle. I've been to the Isle in Pompano. I don't know if it's affiliated or if it's the same company. I mean, the logo's the same. Who knows? This feels nice. Self-serve coffee and sodas. I just realized something. I think all the casinos are smoke-free because that's the second smoking patio I've seen off the side of a casino. Wonder how cold that water is. Pretty damn cold, I suspect. Might as well cross the street and take a walk through the aisle while we're down here. Look like a couple hoodlums standing out here in front of the doors, though. Look like they're up to no good. How you doing? All right. I don't know if it was their intention at Ameristar, but they sure have the hotel fucking hidden. I mean, it is hidden. So here we are in the room at Ameristar on the 18th floor. Let me show you around. You got your little toilet room over there. You got your little sinks over here. Comes with your very own trooper. You got the old, and then the old, right? Then you got the mirror right here, so when you walk out naked, you can do the helicopter. What? You got a door to a stranger's room. Always make sure that shit's locked. Then you got a couple of beds over here, yeah?
got the old double queen non-smoking shit. And then you can look out the window at the town view.
I now realize that I'm starving. I gotta go downstairs, get my bag, come back up here. I have a $10 food credit here that I didn't know that I had because I booked the room online. Nice.
Grilled chicken action. I forgot to say no tomato.
Not getting proper sleep is hitting me a little bit, but the chicken sandwich is good, other than the fact that it was a little undercooked, a little pink in the middle. It was still good. All right, let's grab a coffee and hit the booker room. Had to get a little Black Hawk Colorado coffee cam action, right? Book room is on the second floor. Colorado. First thing, that shit is so loud. Why is there always loud noises around when I'm trying to talk to you guys? I was wrong about something. This is not an Indian reservation. It's just an old mining town, and it's in a certain county that legalized gambling a long time ago. Anyway, I had two games to choose from tonight. I had 1-2 or 2-5. Both of the same betting structure, $2 minimum, $100 maximum, and then the buy-in is different on the game. I think it's 200 minimum for 2-5, 100 minimum for the other game. I'm so tired, I'm about to fall out. I just quit the game. Where are we? The fuck? So I win 157. I was in the game for 5, I started with 3, I lost kind of a decent sized pot, and then I loaded 2 more, so I'm in for 5, and I cash out for $657. So it's definitely not a bad first stop, and I'm actually gonna head to the room and go to sleep. 6 people I met tonight that watched the vlog. First of all, shout out to Todd and Rhonda. I ran into Todd tonight, thank you for the coffee, and Rhonda, I hear that your love for coffee is just as big as mine. So thanks very much for that. And also James, thank you James for the coffee. It's completely unnecessary, you know that, but thank you very much. And I also met two dudes that didn't tell me their name. We just said hello briefly. And then the dealer, since I was in seat 1, I don't know your name. My bad, man. And then also another guy came up to me while I was talking to Todd, and I don't remember if you told me your name, but so my apologies on that. But nice to meet all of you, and yeah, trooper across America. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. I'll see you next time.